vergessen? What have we here? The Tournai's champion!
Greetings. I hope your search goes well.
Would you craft something for me?
Of course.
Farewell.
Good luck on the path. Another murder by the horrid beast! Milton de Peyrac Peyron falls victim to his own cowardice! The beast of Beauclair has struck again! Citizens, beware of the beast! Turn your trembling hearts to the...
I must say, madam, that Witcher's rather...
Whoa there, Roach! Move it!
The Witcher! The one that Duquesa summoned!
Reginald Aubrey has returned, not to be
nice tune.
Buy your tickets now, available from me alone.
What's new, Silverlocks? Looking for diversion?
Reginald Aubrey has returned, not to be missed. Buy your tickets now.
Well, go on. Stroke them.
You must be jesting. To stroke a stranger? Even if it is just a statue.
For as a friend, him you would fondle.
Can't believe I'm actually doing this.
So, behold, the famous Reginald Dobry. The man with the donkeys. Determination.
He must have been breathtaking. Truly, I would so have loved to meet him.
Bah, a statue like any other. A nude chap, nothing extraordinary.
And the genitals, overblown, most certainly.
Aubrey has returned, not to be missed. Buy your tickets now.
Take it easy.
Your glow, scent marking times like a daisy curl flow. They ventured beyond walls by vines entwined, into the unknown the poor barber to find. Bidding them farewell, the gravestones must covered, they strode briskly on by doubts unencumbered. The witch's great flesh juices spouted and poured, covering all about in Anarchispor's gore. No piece of the stylist fell from its bowels. The fissure had been nabbed by aught else most foul. Oh no, foul bandits have bound a stylist in chains. Little do they know they'll be punished in pain. They froze in their fear, the knight's henchmen and squires, while his bowels set loose, heaven would spiral. The witcher cleft him in two lacerated, his neck swing the swine adroitly castrated. With one more caress from the witcher's blade,
dark
the knight's guts popped out, his breakfast betrayed. Then hobbled apace on his stump palms like crutches, all for the glory of her grace.
Faster.
Hey there. Faster. Hey there.
Oh, you scared me half to death, Drifter. What do they call you? What's your crest? Speak!
Geralt of Rivia, Crest of the Bridge. Hail and well met. Francois Legoff, I presume. Your betrothed sent me. See, you've been gone a while, so you've got her worried.
Well, indeed, for Grotore is a most fearsome beast. I must prepare properly for battle.
By napping outside the cave for a fortnight?
I have tarried a bit, true, but the delay is done. My word I gave, thus the beast shall die.
Wouldn't happen to need any help, would you?
I don't know. After all, I did swear a solemn oath to...
Deposit the beast's head at your beloved's feet. No mention of you killing it all by yourself, though.
All in all, I suppose you're right. We must fight side by side, then. For honor!
I should be the one to lop off its head.
We gotta kill it first. Strange. No sign of Grotore.
Perhaps we should turn back? If there's no beast, there's no beast. Damn shame, but we tried.
Not so fast. Let's take a look around. winter garden.
By my troth, the damned brute was sturdy.
I'm grateful, Witcher. You aided me greatly.
Why the challenge? Couldn't have gone after something less formidable? A werebub, for instance?
Why? For the beast must match in ferocity the very ardor of my affection, and...
You're blushing, Sir Knight.
Oh, it's my betrothed. The thing is, she champs at the pit to get married when we've not known one another but 2 years. So I vowed to slay Gratori. Thought it would buy me time to battle such a beast. Why, it could take months.
Especially at the rate you were going.
High time you returned to Beauclair, brave knight.
Nay, nay. The head of this beast is a trifle wholly inadequate to express the love I harbor for my betrothed. The world awaits. To honor her, I shall cut down another, more terrible beast.
Must have really cold feet. Frozen. Can't say I see it happening, your success. But do what you will, and good luck.
My thanks, Master. To fight at your side was an honor.
Come on, Roach. Whoa there, Roach.
Help! Help us!
Someone! Please! Help!
What's this about?
Monsters! Monsters there, in the cave!
We managed to flee, but Hugo remains inside!
Hugo?
Our brother! He's still in there, inside! Help us find him! We'll pay you for your toil!
You post that notice about an escort?
Yes, we did. And not without cause, it seems. We waited some days, yet when none answered, we risked the expedition unaccompanied.
Fools we were. We'd have done better to show patience. Wait! Poor Hugo. Left to an unknown fate.
Noticed what attacked you?
There was no time! We ran for the exit as soon as we felt the earth quiver. But Hugo, well, he went the other way.
So, monsters crawl out of the ground?
I suppose... In truth, I don't know. We just ran. Did not look back.
Why do you even go in there?
We... lost our way.
Mistake that cave for the high road?
By the hair on my chinny chin chin, what difference does it make whether we went in for a stroll or to gather students? Hugo remains inside, in grave danger. That's what matters. Will you go in after him or not? Every second could be vital.
I could look into it, but it'll cost you.
How much would you take?
A reasonable price.
Fine. I'll look for him. You two stay out here.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be. Fresh blood on the blade. Weapon was Hugo's, maybe. Blood trail. Could be Hugo's wounded. Warm and damp. Kikimoors prefer cooler environments. Probably why they keep their distance. You, Hugo? Your brother sent me.
Yeah! Dizzards! Scoundrels! Tartmongers! They attacked me, but I fended them off! Now, they sent a brigand to finish the job!
Not a brigand. I'm a witcher. And your brother sent me to help you.
No, 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 no! I refuse to believe they had a sudden change of heart! They tried to kill me, then sent help? I sense the stench of treachery a mile off!
Whoa, slow down. What's this about?
I'm Hugo Monar. My father, Victor Monar, you may have heard of. A cognac distiller he was, famed for it. Before he passed, my brothers and I would quarrel over who would inherit the family business. So, father decided he would force us to work together. He broke his still down into its parts. Three of them he hid, telling each of us the location of one. When my brothers learned my part, the last, was hidden in here, they decided they did not need me anymore. They decided to cut me out of the business, literally. We argued, fought. The noise must have woken the beasts. My brothers ran for the mouth, while I ran deeper in.
What about the missing part? Find it?
No. I know only that it's in this cave, likely at the bottom of a pool. I feel awkward to ask, but as I am wounded, would you be kind and retrieve it?
Fine. I can do that.
But you must know, I cannot pay you well.
Figured as much. Start producing cognac, I'll come by for a discount.
That, I promise you.
Wait here.
Thank you.
fire's hot. Get burned if I don't watch it. Could use some protection. Maybe Quinn will work. Found the missing part. Really hit that well, your father.
Oh, that's fantastic. Your pay. It is not much, I know. But I promise you good prices. The best once the tavern is open again.
Hold you to that. Now let's go. Brothers are probably getting antsy.
Wait, see there? My brothers! They've rounded up some thugs. They mean to attack me!
We don't know that.
Would you try to tell me it's a coincidence? That they return with an armed band? They've come for the last part of the still. They would kill me for it. Please, you're my only hope. Kill them. Elsewise, they'll kill me.
Kill your brothers? You want that?
Well, perhaps not them, but the other roughs, for certain. As to my brothers, I don't know. You couldn't perhaps render them harmless? Will you defend me?
Not about to start cutting folk down because of a family squabble about some spare bit of machinery. We're going over there, and you're gonna settle this. Talk it out.
But... should they attack, you will protect me, will you not?
If they attack, unprovoked. Let's go.
Hugo! Are you well?
We were worried!
Why do I doubt this?
Listen, while you were in there, we realized this tiff is... senseless, idiotic. You might have been harmed, gravely, and that's something we could never live down.
Lucien is right. We must bury this hatchet, work together as Father wished it.
Claim to come in peace. But then who are these men?
Hunters, who had made camp nearby. They spotted us and asked if we had no need for their aid.
You went in, were gone a long time. With his men to help, we thought we might come to your rescue.
All right, glad to see you've made up. Now I really need to get back to my own affairs.
Naturally.
your payment.
We thank you for your help. Should you ever find yourself near the Clever Clogs, you must stop in. Superb cognac. Some of the best.
Will do. So long.
You'll frighten me, kiddies. You'll frighten me, kiddies.
I'll finally be able to drink in peace. And I'll drink to your health, Witcher.
They paid me to do. That's it.
That grant would be the end of me.
Something seriously wrong here.
Work, yet they had to drink themselves sick.
You came, you saw, you helped. Thank you, Witcher.
Master Liam and Maid Matilda. Why, they'll have a tale to hold their kitties wrapped. A man who dare not down some red is a man whose wife's like to thump his
Lay
head.
About monks, sluggards, skivers. Greetings.
And what do you get for all that work?
Bloody
the cook
hell.
In your back? What's so uninjurious?
Mm.
hard on the nerves, eh? That's why you're so great.
Feed a pack of hounds.
Bloody hell.
Come on, Roach.
Go, go.
Be bum poked. You must hang on, milady. Stay with me a bit longer, Lady Daphne.
You, Jacob?
Heal, Mohort. Down. Who asks?
A witcher. Saw your notice.
Hold up. A witcher, you say? Like in Luis Herrera's Tales and Fables. Luckier than a green, bleeding leprechaun I am. See, not a soul around believes this tree is Daphne, the cursed lady of legend. But you, you could lift the curse.
Bit too old to believe in bedtime stories, aren't you?
Want your chops busted, Witcher? How old I am, that is none of your porking concern.
Fair point. Not my business what you believe, either.
Ha! Huh. I'm content we see eye to eye.
So what makes you think there's a girl cursed inside the tree?
Well, I came out with my dog, Mohold, to cut her down. Axe in hand, a broad swing I took. The edge burrowed deep in her trunk, and bum botch me if blood didn't spurt forth. My jaw dropped in the dirt, but right then I knew every jot of it in the tale of Daphne, Gareth, and the Witch of Lynx, Craig.
Don't tell me. From Herrera's Tales and Fables.
You porking bet. Second edition. Amended in octavo. Those tales by heart. My nan read them to put me to sleep.
Guess she read it cover to cover, colophon included. Got me curious, gotta admit. You really think the old tales are true?
Taking the weepy, are you? Do you think me balmy?
No, it's just these are dark, grim times. No room for knights pure of heart or happily ever afters. So I don't often run into folk like you.
Yes, true, the times are crud, Pai. But I see this as all the more reason to remember the tales. My gran would say, if you know not what to do, think to the chessboard knight and noble Alondra, and the path they would choose. She schooled me so thorough in it, I could not do otherwise even if I wished to.
Let me take a look at the tree.
Careful now. Stay with me.
Swear I hear sobs in the rustling leaves. Actually does bleed. Looks like human blood too. And the bark resembles hypertrophic scars in places. Medallions humming like crazy. Intense magic at work here. Logger was making good time. Strange, though. Willows isolated. No other trees near it. Blood. Seeped from the direction of the tree, judging by the shape of the stain.
And? Did you look at the tree close?
Mm-hmm. Actually does bleed. Pretty incredible. Looks wondrous.
Did I not say so?
My help doesn't come free, you know.
You speak to a lowly woodcutter. No stench of coin about me. Agreed. I will pay as soon as the young mate is free.
Willing to help, but first I gotta figure out where to start.
No need. I know it all. Miss Daphne and Sir Gareth shared a terrible and fearsome love for each other. Yet to prove himself worthy of her hint, Gareth was to face the Witch of Lynx Crag. Before Sir Gareth set off for the hill, Miss Daphne gave him her kerchief, a token of her favor.
Let me guess, he never returned.
He did not. She stood here, day upon day, night upon night, trying to spy him.
Till she sprouted roots and turned into a tree? Wonder why.
I will fecking tell you why. To await the moment when Gareth returns, kerchief in hand. That is the power of love. The power of longing. So you must scale Lynx Crag. Search there for a means to free Daphne. I will give you my book of tales to refer to. And good luck, Witcher.
If only I had the coin for a medic.
No one gives a hoot about us poor folk.
Wanna go to the port? Maybe there's some new ships.
Come on now. Not attacking. Doesn't mean it's not a threat, though. Inhabited. No sign of the dweller, though. Guess I'll look around.
smells inconclusive. No idea what ingredients are in there. Notes on the use of yarrow stems. Interesting. Ground into dust. A wall of spell enhancements or trophies. Arrow broken in half. No doubt to bring bad luck to the archer. Branch off a grapevine. Could be to ensure a good harvest, or a bad one. Doll looks like an accessory for casting curses. Silk kerchief, monogrammed DF. Could use it to break the curse if it's Daphne's.
None but feral cats stray in here most oft. Yet it seems I forgot from afar that. What do you seek in my home?
Already found it.
You do not aim to lift the curse from the tree, girl.
What if I do?
Then you had best know you waste your time. The old tales? Did your Nan not tell them to you? Even I, the Witch of Lynx Crag, would be hard-pressed to overcome the power of love and longing.
The Lady's Knight, he ever make it here?
Sir Gareth. Yes, he came to sway me. But had a quick change of heart. To be precise, it came after the first night we spent together. He stayed a fair while. Then his conscience got the better of him, and he resolved to return to his beloved.
Might have resolved to, but never made it.
A tragic fate befell him along the way.
You have anything to do with this turn of fate?
Of course. Was I to let another woman have a man who belonged to me?
What if I asked you nicely to lift the curse, please?
Gareth met the fate he deserved, and what happened to his wench was not my fault.
All right, so you didn't cast the curse, but could you help lift it?
I probably could, but why ever would I?
I'll humble myself. Prostrate myself before you like the Gareth of the tale did. I beseech you to help me. Lift the curse that imprisoned Daphne in the tree.
When I saw you enter my hut, I thought, now there is a fellow who shall bend his neck for no one. Stand. Nan. Not even I can restore to the last the years she has lost, can erase the suffering she has endured. We cannot bring her back to life, but I shall tell you how you might let her depart in peace. Yet my aid shall have its price. A lock of your hair.
How can I know you won't use it to cast a spell on me?
I require this. I must, for with it I will cast a spell to conceal me from you for all time, and will use it for nothing else. You will nag me never again, and you've nothing to fear, I assure you. I always keep my word.
Not about to trust you with a lock of my hair or anything else. I'll handle the curse myself without your help.
Go right ahead. I wish you luck.
Letting me go, just like that?
I could not have devised a better ending for this little tale. Our visit is done. Adieu. For never shall we meet again.
Some bones. Gareth's remains. These them. Wonder why the armor came apart. Magic. Or he just fall from a height.
will not find work here. Not paying work, that is.
Run, Roach.
Sweet mother of mine.
So, you met the witch you must have. What did you learn?
That witch, she's not near as bad as folks say. Made me bow and scrape, sure. But I know some sorceresses witchier than her.
Joyous bleeding news, but what about Daphne?
I can lift the curse, free her. By performing a ritual, making a sacrifice of her kerchief and Gareth's remains. But we gotta start at the right time. When the hour comes, I'll light four fires for the four winds, then begin the ritual.
Fires? Then I shall be of use to you after all. Seems you need wood, much of it.
Chop as much as you can. I'll see to the rest.
I've chopped and stacked the wood. What now?
My turn. Gotta light fires and talk to the woman enchanted in the tree. No idea how this'll turn out, so just in case, stand at a distance. And if you see me draw my sword, run. Last to the world's four winds. From the south, not a word. From the east, no cry is heard. From the north, silent sighs. Peer hollow eyes, cease your vigil. Dead he lies. Hear me, you who hide beneath this bark. Recall today who you really are. Behold a kerchief, proof of your love for another. Behold, a bone of he to whom you offered your love.
Gareth, my Gareth, he shall never return.
No, he won't.
Is his love for me gone? Did he stay true?
Gareth broke his vow, failed to stay faithful.
Man is built of mud and filth, m'lady, and is like to blunder, we all are.
How cruel is the world to render conferring one's love so hard?
But what would the world be without love?
The time comes that I depart. I've waited too long. I've suffered too much. And now I wish to go.
Farewell, m'lady.
I thank you, stranger. And you, my knight. I thank you for speaking to me. For standing vigil at my feet.
I did not think it would end this way. I hoped we could revive her, but I guess it was not to be.
We did all we could.
You did well. Here, your pay. And the book is yours as well.
Thanks. Take care of yourself.
So long, Witcher. I must think, put this straight in my head.
They paid me to. That's it.
Conniffing, I'm off to the bells, quick as a flash. Those girls can't wait to see me.
Will be the end
my
of
hand me. Shakes so bad. I cannot hold my tools.
What they paid me to do, that's it.
Come on.
Seriously wrong here.
Show me what you got.
Damn, you're ugly.
Never ever trust a woman, remember that.
that scene looks like and expired. Or did something kill her? Wonder what'll happen if I reenact the scene. Need to backtrack along her prints, then light the candles in the same order she did. Drink. Stench. Somewhere. Something here. Where's that artifact Kira gave me?
I was young. Have you heard? Some knight snapped Jean-Louis.
Good news. You're betrothed.
He's my betrothed no more.
What?
He was just here, just departed, having made a new vow, this time to fetch me a striped horse from Zeracania.
Well, at least he chose something he stands to accomplish on his own. Quite the trek, though.
Precisely. I told him I require no more proof. Let us make haste to the temple. He began hemming and whoring, babbling about honor and whatnot. Ugh. Tell me, Master Witcher, are all men swine?
Not all. A few exceptions out there.
Ugh. Perhaps in your distant Rivia. But what care have you for my heart's woes? Your reward, as I vowed. And advice, should you ever find yourself a Lady Witcher, be truthful with her to save the world some grief.
Yes.
Thank you once more for coming to my rescue. Ah, but where are my manners? Master Witcher, allow me to introduce myself. I am Jean-Louis Ludovic, a magna cum laude graduate of the Le Mans Poilu Cosmetology Institute. Please consider my scissors and razor at your disposal.
So long.
I shall cling to my scissors and comb as long as I've strength left in my fingers.
Oh, fuck.
Corpus speculiota. Man's root for lust is the coin of all evil.
Is this what booming means? Cognac selling like fresh buns on the morn. Pleased customers screaming about.
Fathers, this is where we work together. Do you see the wisdom of it now?
Yes. Papa knew. Papa knew this would work.
Ah, Witcher, greetings. What brings you here?
See, you made up with your brothers. Looks like business is good.
All true, all true. I cannot complain. We'd been rivals all our lives. So, at first, it was hard to agree on anything. Yet, gradually, we realized we had no other options. Suddenly, it turned out we work well together.
Nice to hear.
And we've you to thank for it. Had we not met you, nothing would have come of our quarrels but heartache. Thank you, Witcher.
Glad I could help. Wouldn't mind a drink, some good wine or cognac.
Be my guest. Pick and choose as you will.
Time I was on my way. Farewell.
Renounce your sins. The beast shall devour all.
I'm glad to see her illustrious grace summon such a...
Hark, Beauclerois! Her most gracious duchess has hired a witcher to get at the root of these murders. Every resident of our fair town is hereby required to aid the witcher in any way he requests. The top do this season, a coif beyond compare from the friseur Jean-Louis Ludovic. The latest in cuts and styles in the Koviri court fashion. Jean-Louis Ludovic, for the ladies, for the gentlemen, northern fashions to suit the southern style.
Greetings.
I hope your search goes well.
What do you have on offer?
Thank you.
Farewell.
Good luck on the path.
For the history of Toussaint Friends Society. Citizens, beware of history and elves alike. And
best
so,
behave.
Human or otherwise.
You're in Beauclair.
Your glow, sent marking times at 13.